Hi everyone, Miggy from Figma here with another Figma tip. Let's talk about resizing frames. So let's say you have a frame here, it has some content inside and you want to resize it. So if I go to resize it, you'll notice that the content is just kind of sticking to the top left. So even if I move from the left-hand side or the top, the content is moving with that. So there's a couple things that you need to consider when you want to resize a frame and what you want it to do. So the first thing I'm gonna do here is if I want to scale this frame, I'm gonna go ahead and press the K key, and that's gonna allow me to basically scale everything up and down as needed, okay? And I'm gonna return back to the normal selection tool by pressing V. So next, let's start talking about constraints and what that means. So right now, basically, as I resize this, and you can see that I already have some constraints set on those, I'm gonna set them back to the default. And what I'm gonna do here is, as I try to scale this, you'll see everything is, once again, is on the top left. So what you can do is actually set different constraints for all of these items. So I'm gonna set this one to right and top. I'm gonna select both of these and set them to the center, so center and center. And I'm gonna set this one to the left, and the vertical constraint to the bottom, and then this one to the right and to the bottom. So now when I go to scale that, you will see that it's honoring the constraints of all of those elements. So basically that's what's happening when you're typically doing any type of resizing. To ignore the constraints, what you want to do is hold down the command key or the control key on Windows. So if I hold down the command key in any direction that I pull this, it's effectively ignoring the constraints of my frame. So next, if I want to scale it out from the center, what I can do is hold down Command and Option or Control and Alt on a PC as I drag this, and you'll see the content will ignore the constraints from the center. Likewise, if I only hold down the Option key, you'll see from the center, it'll acknowledge all of those constraints. So next, when you're dealing with a grid and you have a grid layout like this, you can use constraints to set objects to that grid. I'm gonna select both of these and set left and right constraints as well. Actually, I'm just gonna go ahead and select everything that I have here and use left and right constraints with my horizontal grid. And what they're gonna do is they're actually snapping to the grid layout elements. And that's once again over here in the layout grid panel. Next, same thing, I have a vertical grid, or I have actually rows here, and I want to align the vertical alignment to be the top and the bottom. So I'm gonna select all of my elements. I'm gonna say top and bottom. So then as I increase the size of that, you see all of these images scale and match that. So the way that that works is basically those images are filled, so they're filling up the space on those shapes. Lastly here, if you wanna talk about clipping, if I clip my content and I hold down the command key to ignore constraints, you'll see that I basically frame out all of the content in my frames. If I hit Command Y though, you'll actually see how they exist within that frame. And if I want to unclip, I can just go ahead and click that panel, and you can see that that gets unclipped just like that as I'm resizing it. And as I'm resizing it, I'm holding down the command key. If I hold down command option or control alt, you can see it'll scale out from the center. I just want to take a moment here and thank everyone for the photos that was on Twitter. This was kind of great. Hope you all learned something today. Happy designing.